A very good morning to all of you. I am Dr. Abhay Deshpande, Associate Professor, RV College of Engineering, Bangalore. And this is my lecture 5 on Unit 5. And today's concept is propagation in good conductors. So today we are going to learn the propagation in good conductors. And along with that, we are solving few examples and solutions. As implied, a good conductor has a high conductivity and a large conduction current. So the energy represented by the wave traveling through the material, therefore it starts decreasing as the wave propagates because ohmic losses are continuously present in the wave. So hence, according to the general expression for the propagation constant, jk is given by j into k is equal to j omega under root of mu epsilon into under root of 1 plus j sigma divided by omega epsilon, where sigma represents the conductivity of the material. So this can be written as j omega under root mu into sigma, and the value of 1 minus j into sigma by omega epsilon can be written as minus j into sigma divided by omega epsilon, because the value of sigma by omega epsilon will be very much greater than 1 because we are dealing with a very high conductivity, that is for the good conductors. Hence, this equation, that is J into K, can be simplified as J into under root of minus J omega mu into sigma. So we can write that, we know that minus J can be written as 1 at an angle of minus 90. So I substitute the value of minus j in this expression, that is 1 at an angle of minus 90 can be written as 1 divided by 2, that is half 1 divided by root 2 into 1 minus j, that is j into k. In the expression of j into k, this can be written as j into 1 minus j under root of omega mu sigma divided by 2. That is, still this equation can be simplified as 1 plus j under root of pi f mu sigma. But we know that j and k can be written as, that is jk can be written as alpha plus j beta, where alpha is attenuation constant and beta is phase constant. So if you equate j and k, jk is equal to alpha plus j beta, then we can write both the values of alpha and beta is equal to under root of pi f mu into sigma. And also, the intrinsic impedance eta can be written as under root of j mu omega divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon. But we know that the sigma value is very much greater than omega epsilon. So we can write this intrinsic impedance as j omega mu divided by sigma alone, because we are dealing with conductors. And conductors have very high conductivity, that is sigma value is very much greater than omega into epsilon. So this is the simple derivations what we will do in case of good conductors, the propagation in good conductors. Now based on this concept, that is attenuation constant as well as a phase constant and intrinsic impedance, now we will start solving few examples on conductors. Let us take the first example. that is wet marshy soil is characterized by sigma is equal to 10 to the power minus 2, epsilon r is equal to 15, and mu r is equal to 1, full stop. At frequencies 60 hertz, 1 megahertz, 100 megahertz, and 10 gigahertz, indicate whether soil be considered as a good conductor or a dielectric. So in these different frequencies, we need to check whether the given material will act as a conductor or it will act as a dielectric for the different frequencies. So from the example, the given data is conductivity sigma is equal to 10 to the power minus 2. Epsilon r is 15, mu r is equal to 1. So let us take the first case, case 1, that is f is equal to 60 hertz. Now to check whether the material is a conductor or a dielectric, we need to calculate the ratio, that is sigma divided by omega epsilon, and based on the value of sigma by omega epsilon, we can conclude the material at which it is traveling. So sigma by omega epsilon, sigma divided by omega value is 2 pi f, and epsilon value is epsilon naught into epsilon r. So this is equal to 10 to the power minus 2, that is sigma value divided by 2 pi f is frequency. I have taken as a first case, that is 60 hertz, into epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r value is 50. So let us calculate the ratio sigma by omega epsilon, and we will get this value as sigma by omega epsilon is equal to 1.9972 into 10 to the power 5. So this value, that is sigma by omega epsilon, is very much greater than 1. Hence, as the value of the ratio is very high compared to unity, the given material, that is wet marshy soil, acts as a conductor at 60 hertz. Similarly, for the second case, let us check at 1 megahertz. The entire numericals remain same. Only the value of F will change. Instead of 60, we need to enter 1 mega. That is case 2, sigma by omega epsilon, sigma by 2 pi F into epsilon naught into epsilon R, and 2 pi F. F value is 10 to the power 6. Because second case, F is equal to 1 megahertz, we are calculating. And in this case, sigma by omega epsilon, we will get it as 11.9836 will be the ratio of sigma by omega epsilon. And still, if you see, the value of this is very much greater than 1. So again, at f is equal to 1 megahertz, it acts as a conductor. Now let us take the third case, that is f is equal to 100 megahertz. So at 100 megahertz, f is equal to 100 into 10 to the power 6. Rest all the values will remain same. 10 to the power minus 12 divided by 2 pi into 100 into 10 to the power 6. Epsilon naught 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r is 50. Substitute this and calculate the value of sigma by omega epsilon. So the value of sigma by omega epsilon is less than 1. So now at f is equal to 100 megahertz, the material will act as a lossy dielectric because the value is less than 1. Now similarly, let us calculate at f is equal to 10 gigahertz. So substitute f is equal to 10 gigahertz and calculate the value. So now we will get it as 0.0012. So which is very much lesser than 1. Hence the given material will act as a perfect dielectric. So if it is less than 1, it will act as a dielectric. And it is greater than 1, it will act as a conductor. Let us take the example 2, second example. Determine alpha, beta, gamma, velocity v, lambda, and intrinsic impedance eta for damp soil at a frequency of 1 megahertz given epsilon r equal to 12, mu r is equal to 1, and sigma conductivity is 20 millimo per meter. That is 20 milli conductivity. Now let us check first whether it will really behave as a conductor. That is sigma divided by omega epsilon, we need to calculate the ratio, and sigma by omega is 2 pi f, epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. Now substitute, sigma is equal to 20 milli, that is 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 divided by 2 pi f, that is 2 pi into 10 to the power 6, frequency is 1 megahertz, and epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12, and epsilon r value is 12. Substitute this and calculate the ratio of sigma divided by omega epsilon. So sigma by omega epsilon value becomes 29.96. The ratio of sigma by omega epsilon will become 29.96, which is again greater than 1. Hence, from the value of the ratio sigma by omega epsilon at a frequency of 1 megahertz, the damp soil will act as a quasi conductor. It will start behaving as a conductor. Now we will calculate the value of alpha, beta, gamma. So let us calculate the value of gamma, which is nothing but alpha plus j beta. So from that itself we will get the value of both attenuation constant and phase constant. So let us start with the propagation constant is equal to under root of j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. Now j omega mu, j as it is, omega is 2 pi f, f value they have given as 1 megahertz, 10 to the power 6 omega, mu value, mu naught into mu r value is 1, hence mu naught value is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. Into sigma, sigma value is 20 milli, they have given in the numerical, hence 20 into 10 to the power minus 3 plus j omega value, this value into epsilon. Epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r, and epsilon r value they have given it as 12. So hence epsilon naught value is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. So let us substitute all this and calculate the value of propagation constant. Let us simplify and calculate the value of gamma propagation constant. So we will get it as 0.3973 at an angle of 45 degrees. So same thing can be represented in terms of alpha plus j beta. So alpha plus j beta can be written as 0.2809 plus j 0.2809. So we can definitely say that alpha value is equal to beta value. So So it is a conductor, hence it should be equal, that is alpha value as well as beta value. Now let us calculate the velocity, that is v is equal to omega by beta. Omega value is 2 pi f by beta. So 2 pi f, f is 1 mega, so 1 into 10 to the power 6 divided by beta. And beta we have just calculated as 0.2809. Hence, V becomes 22.36 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second. The V value becomes 22.36 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second. That is the velocity. Now, once if we know the value of V, we can calculate the wavelength lambda as lambda is equal to 2 pi by beta. 2 pi divided by beta value is 0.2809. We have to substitute 2 pi by beta. And lambda value we will get is as 22.368 meters. The value of wavelength lambda is equal to 22.368. Now let us calculate the intrinsic impedance eta. Eta is equal to j omega mu divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon. Now substitute all the values. That is j into 2 pi f into mu naught mu r divided by sigma plus j into 2 pi f into epsilon naught epsilon r. Substitute the values and calculate the intrinsic impedance eta in terms of ohms. Calculate in terms of ohms. So we will get it as 19.869 at an angle of 44.05 degree ohms. So this will be the intrinsic impedance. Now let us take the next example. A uniform plane wave is traveling at a velocity of 2.5 into 10 to the power 5 meter per second, having a wavelength lambda is equal to 0.25 millimeters in a non-magnetic good conductor. Calculate the frequency of wave and the conductivity of a medium. So I need frequency f and the conductivity, that is sigma. They have given the velocity as well as the wavelength, and it's a non-magnetic good conductor. Hence, the velocity of propagation is given by v is equal to f lambda. The velocity we know it as v is equal to f lambda. Hence, from this, frequency f is equal to v divided by lambda. So, v value we know it as 2.5 into 10 to the power plus 5 divided by lambda value is 0.5 millimeter. Hence, 0.5 into 10 to the power minus 3. Now simplify this and get the value of frequency f. So frequency f we will get it as 1 into 10 to the power 9 hertz, that is 1 gigahertz. Now we need to calculate the conductivity sigma. Hence, we will calculate by using the equation, that is velocity of propagation is given by v is equal to omega by beta. Omega value is 2 pi f divided by beta. And from this, beta value is equal to 2 pi f divided by v, then 2 pi f, f value is 1 giga, we have calculated. So 1 into 10 to the power 9 divided by v, velocity value is 2.5 into 10 to the power 5. And calculate the value of beta, and we will get beta as 25.1327 into 10 to the power 3 radian per meter. That is the phase constant you have calculated. But we know that for good conductor, the phase constant is given by beta is equal to under root pi f mu into sigma. So pi f mu value is mu naught mu r into sigma. So mu r value is equal to 1, and mu naught value, let us substitute mu naught value as 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. So here we know the value of beta, we know pi, we know f value, we know mu naught value, as well as mu r value is 1. So only the unknown value is sigma. So let us calculate the value of sigma conductivity from this. So you get it as 1.6 into 10 to the power 5 is the value of conductivity. Now the next question, example 4, fourth example. That is, the amplitude of E, that is electric field intensity, just inside a liquid is 10 volt per meter, full stop. For a liquid, constants are mu r equal to 1, epsilon r is 20, and sigma equal to 0.5. Now we need to determine the amplitude of E at a distance of 10 centimeter inside the medium. For frequencies of 5 megahertz, 50 megahertz, and 500 megahertz. We need to calculate the amplitude of E. Now, the amplitude of E at a 10 centimeter inside a liquid is given by Em is equal to e to the power minus alpha d is the expression for amplitude, where d is 10 centimeter, Em is 10 volt per meter, and frequency f is 5 megahertz. Now, in this expression of Em into e to the power minus alpha d, I need the value of alpha, that is attenuation constant. Hence, the propagation constant is given by gamma is equal to j omega mu into sigma plus j omega mu, and substitute all the values. J omega is 2 pi f, mu is mu naught mu r, sigma as it is plus j 2 pi f into epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. So substitute all the values, that is mu r is equal to 1, epsilon r equal to 20, and conductivity sigma is 0.5, and the frequency is, first case is 5 mega. So I have substituted 5 into 10 to the power 6. And now I will simplify the value of gamma. Simplify the expression, gamma is equal to if you calculate, we will get the value as 4.4428 at an angle of 45.32 degrees. Hence, we can write in terms of alpha plus j beta as 3.123 plus j 3.159. So from this, we will get the value of alpha as 3.123. Hence, the expression for E is equal to 10 into e to the power minus alpha value is 3.123 into d value, distance is 10 into 10 to the power minus 2. Hence, we will get the amplitude as 7.3176 volt per meter. Now, similarly, we need to do for 50 megahertz. So, rest all values remain same. Only the F value in the previous case, it was 5 into 10 to the power 6. And now it is 50 into 10 to the power 6. Rest all values will remain same. And using this, calculate the value of, again, alpha plus j beta. That means we need the value of alpha. Calculate the value of alpha. So alpha value, we will get it as 9.3969. The value of alpha, we will get it as 3.9.3969. The value of alpha, you get it as 9.3969. Hence, if we substitute, the amplitude E becomes 3.9074 volt per meter. Substitute this alpha value, 9.3969. into 10 into 10 to the power minus 2, and we will get amplitude as 3.9074 volt per meter. Now same procedure we need to do for F is equal to 500 mega. That means 500 into 10 to the power 6 we need to substitute, and again we need to calculate the value of alpha and beta. That is propagation constant we need to calculate, and from that the value of alpha. Let us calculate the value of alpha. And we'll get alpha value is equal to 19.4507. Hence, the amplitude E becomes 10 into e to the power minus 19.4507 into 10 into 10 to the power minus 2. Hence, if we solve for E, we will get 1.4297 volt per meter will be the answer. So, this is how we need to calculate the electric field in all the three frequencies. Now, next question. A lossy dielectric has mu r equal to 1 and epsilon r equal to 50 and conductivity is 60 at 15.9 megahertz. And we need to calculate the velocity value and intrinsic impedance. If the uniform plane wave is traveling through this medium, now to calculate, first, I need the value of alpha beta. So, for that, I will use the propagation constant equation gamma is equal to under root of j omega mu into sigma plus j omega epsilon. So j omega, omega is 2 pi f, f value is 15.9 mega. So 2 pi into 15.9 into 10 to the power 6 omega mu value is mu naught into mu r is 1, hence mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7. Then we have sigma plus j omega epsilon, sigma value is 60, j omega epsilon, epsilon is epsilon r into epsilon naught. And epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12. And epsilon r is 50. Substitute. Calculate the value of propagation constant. Propagation constant gamma is equal to 61.3413 plus j. 61.3841 we will get. So comparing the real and imaginary, we can calculate the value of alpha and beta. So alpha value is 61.3413 and beta value is 61.3841. Now once if you know the value of beta in radian per meter, we can calculate the velocity of propagation, and it is given by v is equal to omega by beta. Omega value is 2 pi f. F is 15.9 mega. Hence 15.9 into 10 to the power 6 divided by beta. Beta is 61.3841. So from this calculate the value of velocity v. And velocity v we will get it as 1.6275 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second. We will get the value as 1.6275 into 10 to the power 6 meter per second. Now we will calculate the intrinsic impedance eta is equal to under root of j omega mu divided by sigma plus j omega epsilon. Hence j omega, omega is 2 pi f and f is 15.9 into 10 to the power 6. Mu is mu naught into mu r. Mu naught is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 and mu r is equal to 1. Divided by sigma. Sigma is 60 in the given problem. It is 60 sigma value plus j omega value 2 pi f and epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r and epsilon naught is 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 into epsilon r is 50. Calculate the value of intrinsic impedance in ohms. So you get intrinsic impedance as 1.4465 at an angle of 44.98 degree ohms. So this is the value of intrinsic impedance what we will get from the example. Next example, a block of copper, sigma equal to 5.8 into 10 to the power 7, supports a 60 hertz plane wave. Now compute the loss tangent and the intrinsic impedance of the medium. So as we have studied in the previous concepts, the loss tangent is nothing but sigma by omega epsilon. So calculate the value of sigma by omega epsilon. That is sigma by omega is 2 pi f and epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. and frequency they have given 60 hertz. So 2 pi into 60 into 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 and calculate the value of loss tangent. So you get the loss tangent value as 1.738 into 10 to the power 6 . Now we know that copper is a good conductor. So for good conductors, the intrinsic impedance is under root of omega mu by sigma at an angle of 45 degree. So substitute the values of omega, that is 2 pi of f is 60 hertz, into mu is 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7 divided by sigma. Conductivity is 5.8 into 10 to the power 7. So from this we can calculate the value of intrinsic impedance. So we'll get intrinsic impedance as 2.86 into 10 to the power minus 6 at an angle of 45 degree ohms. So this is how we will calculate the intrinsic impedance of the medium. Let us take the next example. Determine the propagation constant at 500 kilohertz for a medium in which mu r is equal to 1, epsilon r equal to 15 and sigma is equal to 0. Now, at what velocity will an electromagnetic wave travel in this medium? At what velocity will the wave travel in this medium? That means we need to calculate the value of velocity. So looking at the question, the value of epsilon r is 15 and also sigma is equal to 0. That means it's a good dielectric. And for good dielectric, these are the equations. That is alpha is sigma by 2 under root of mu by epsilon. Beta is omega under root mu epsilon into 1 plus sigma square by 8 omega square epsilon square. And B is 1 divided by under root mu epsilon into 1 minus sigma square divided by 8 omega square epsilon square. Now we know that dielectric medium, hence attenuation constant alpha is 0. Now let us calculate a beta phase constant, that is omega under root mu into epsilon, and omega is 2 pi f under root mu into epsilon, mu is mu naught mu r, epsilon is epsilon naught into epsilon r. Substitute the values 2 pi f, f is 500 into 10 to the power minus 3 and mu naught 4 pi into 10 to the power minus 7, mu r is 1, epsilon naught is 15. Epsilon r value. So they have given 500 kilo, that means 500 into 10 to the power 3 plus 3. So using that, substitute the value and calculate the value of beta. Beta, we will get it as 0.04. Beta value will become 0.04. because frequency f is 500 into 10 to the power plus 3. It should be plus 3. Now the velocity v, we will calculate. Velocity v is equal to 1 divided by under root mu into epsilon. And we will substitute the value of mu naught, mu r, epsilon naught, epsilon r. And we will calculate the value of v, velocity v. And we will get it as 7.74 into 10 to the power 7 meter per second. 7.74 into 10 to the power 7 meter per second. Hence, the propagation constant gamma equal to alpha plus j beta, where alpha is 0 and beta value is 0.04, what we have calculated. Or else we can write it as 0.04 at an angle of 90 degree. Now today we have seen for a good conductors how to calculate the attenuation constant alpha, beta, gamma, velocity v, as well as the propagation constant. Now, based on these concepts for good conductor, now let us solve some simple quiz questions. Let us answer some quick quiz questions. First one, for a good conductor, the ratio of sigma by omega epsilon should be, is it greater than 1, less than 1, or equal to 1? Yes, option is first one. It is very much greater than 1. So, answer is option A. Now, the second one. For good conductors, the relation between attenuation constant and the phase constant is it alpha is greater than beta, or alpha is less than beta, or is alpha is equal to beta? Yes, option is option C. For good conductors, the value of alpha should be is equal to value of beta, that is alpha is equal to beta. So these are the answers to the quiz questions, and this is what I wanted to cover today. Thank you all. Thank you very much.